So that's what append does. We're going to introduce two other list operations. The next one is plus. Plus behaves very similar to the concatenation operation for strings. If we have the list 0, 1, plus the list 2, 3, the result is the list 0, 1, 2, 3. So what plus does, like concatenation for strings, is it produces a new list. It doesn't mutate either of the input lists. So I want to introduce one other operator that works on lists, and that's the len operator. Len is short for length. And we use len like this. It looks like a procedure call. We pass into len the object that we want to know the length of. That can be a list. Len actually works for many things other than lists. It also works for strings. It works for any object that's a collection of things. And the output from len is the number of elements in the input. So for example, the result of len applied to the list 0, 1 is 2, since there are two elements in the list. The result of applying len to this list is also 2. It looks like there are many more elements here, but len is only counting the outer elements. So if one of the elements of a list is a list, it doesn't matter how many elements that list contains. It only contributes 1 to the length of the original list. So the result of this call would also be 2. We can also use len on a string, and the output will be the number of characters in the string. In this case, the string Udacity has 7 characters, so the output is 7. So now we're ready for some quizzes to see how well you understand the three list operations we've introduced. The append operation, which is invoked on a list and takes an element as a parameter and adds that element to the end of the list. The plus operator, which operates on two lists as its operands and produces a new list that consists of all the elements in the two lists put together. And finally, the len operator that takes a list as its input and produces as an output a number that is the length of the list, the number of elements in the input list.